Hey everybody, it's Christine Siana Calabrese from What About the Dog with a video today on fleas. I know you're wondering why I'm holding egg hurting. Well, this is going to be video one of a three-part series. Today is just going to be how to identify if your dog has fleas. Part two next week will be how to get rid of said fleas, and part three will be products on what you can use on your dog in your house. But the reason I'm holding this egg carton is because today, if nothing else, I want you to hear, understand, remember that even though a flea's life cycle is only about 2 to 3 months, in that 2 to 3 months, a flea can lay up to 500 eggs. So half your battle, at least half your battle, is going to be getting rid of the eggs. I'm gonna say this in every video, okay? Because it's that important. A lot of people just treat their dogs and they neglect their house, they neglect their cars, and guess what? The cycle just keeps going and they can't get rid of these bitches and they're awful, okay? So let's get into four ways you can identify if your dog has fleas. I'm going to be using my dog Cerebrus, who guards the underworld, as my model today, okay? So this has happened to me where I've suspected my dog had fleas and I try to hunt and peck over the top and, you know, look around and you don't see them because they're fast moving. And that's embarrassing when you think you've looked thoroughly and then you hand the dog off to someone else and they just open the part, the fur, and they're like, oh yeah, there's a flea. So then you feel kind of silly. So the easiest way, the way I do now, is I go right to the belly. Go right to the belly, go right to the groin. That's where they're going to be most noticeable. You'll, more times than not, you can just zone in on them right in this area. Okay, so look there first instead of wasting time looking here, looking here, looking here. Okay, that's number one. Number two, you can look for flea dirt. Flea dirt, aka flea poop. Okay, so I want you to take a white cloth, white paper towel, something like this. I want you to put it down, put your dog on top of it. And just like shaking out dandruff, I want you to rub the dog and I want you to make it rain. I want flea poop falling off, if there is any. It's gonna look like pepper. It's gonna look like little grains. It's gonna be black and it's gonna be a little red maybe because it's undigested blood. Okay, so then you move the dog, you look at the paper, you go, oh, there's flea poop. Okay, that's a good indicator. Number three, the flea comb, okay? Flea comb, this is a flea comb. You see all those teeth? It's got more teeth than that little thing from Trilogy of Terror with the spear. Remember that thing? Woo, that was spooky. Okay, so you wanna take your dog and you want to comb your dog and then periodically look and see if A, you've caught a live flea in the teeth, or B, if you've caught flea eggs in the teeth, okay? They're white, they're kind of opal colored, they're round oval, all right? Here's something that no one tells you, pay attention to this. While you're doing your combing, I want you to take a cup full of water. I like to take a drop of dish soap, put it in there. In between the brushings, the combings, I actually rinse out the brush. Rinse out the comb, okay, and then you want to dry it off because there is no sense in catching flea eggs and not cleaning it off and continuing to comb because now you're just like moving eggs around the dogs. You have to get your stuff clean, okay? So that's number three. Number four, the last one, put your dog in a tub full of water, okay? Fleas will run to high ground, so get that water up nice and high on the neck, all right? I've had clients with fleas who actually just let their dog sit in water and nothing happened. I think these bitches have like scuba gear or something. They can just hang out. So what I need you to do is I need you to rub your dog, massage your dog in the water to break their little monstrous devilish grip. And then you can watch them float away. And then you curse them out as they float away. Okay. So that is that. Please don't let them escape. Don't let them escape off the comb or out of the bathtub. Okay. Just pull that drain and let them go. Those are the four ways, okay? Weather's gonna be getting warmer, we gotta be vigilant. Watch for the next two videos on how to get rid of them and what products you can use for your home and your pets that are safe, okay? And as always, I end with What About the Dog? Found at whataboutthedogbook.com. It's a pre-planning journal, $10 on Amazon. Go to that website, please. It's a great gift. Everything someone would need to know about your dogs, from diet, music selection, anything, you name it, it's in this book. It's everything someone would need to know about your dogs in case, God forbid, something happens to you. Leave this behind. Let people know how to properly care for your dog, okay? What About the Cat? Found at whataboutthecatbook.com. Also, it's on back order. Sorry, I don't have one to show you. All right, so please stay safe, stay vigilant, and we'll see you next week. Bye-bye.